Thank you for joining us for the 2-Minute Drills. The 2013 season has arrived, Freddie. We got a very good one going on Friday night. I will be there at B.L. Bergstrom Stadium at Arroyo High School. Arroyo, the Knights hosting Los Altos.
Jim Freddie, Singheiser special.
Yeah, Jim Singheiser special, Del Zayola special. This was a game that I attended last year, covered on this very same weekend.
Remember, well, I called that blowout too last year.
Yeah, you were across town, I think, doing Amat Servite, and I was at Los Altos. And that game was really over before it ever started, it seemed like. Los Altos jumped all over Arroyo early. They went on to win 33-6, Freddie. And you thought, hey, they're on their way to another, you know, big season. Of course, it was a rebuilding year, and they only ended up 5-5, but they did beat West Covina in league.
Yeah, Los Altos was, I think, one of the strangest teams last year. I mean, they start out 3-0, 33-6, 48-34, beat Wilson 49-0. Then they lose 60-0 to Chino, 40-3 to Diamondback.
Yeah,
it wasn't how they lost. Yeah. It was the way when they won, how they won big, and how they lost, they would just get crushed. You're right. Then they come back and beat West Covina. I was at that game. I think before the week we were talking about, there's just no way in the world Los Altos was going to fare.
No, you said that.
Yeah, against West Covina. And then they go ahead. And then they go ahead and lose to Roland the following week. 28-13, they lose 3 in a row. To Bonita and Diamond Ranch, and then, you know, they beat Walnut in the finale. But what a strange team, and they've got some good players back.
They got everyone
Argos, David Jimenez.
Like, yeah.
I was looking at Christian Hasagaba, Justin O'Neill, Brandon Hayashi. I mean, you're right. They've got a lot of returners and a great coach. I love Dale Zayola.
Yeah, what a job he's done.
He did a great job last year. I think he's a coach that players enjoy playing for.
Yeah.
And I think those things that happened last year, I mean, you know, losing games the way they did, I don't think that's going to happen than this year.
As you recall, 2 years ago, they had that good senior class that he inherited. They surprised the whole Valley, had an 8-win season, almost made the semis, I believe. Or maybe they did make the semis and almost made the finals. But last year they were rebuilding, and they had to replace all those key guys. Now all those key guys are back. You got to watch out for David Jimenez this year. That guy's going to be a freak on the D-line, Freddie. And Estuardo Marcos, that kid, he's on the preseason all-area team as all-purpose because he's a dynamic kick returner. He's a fantastic running back. He's compact. He disappears. If he gets in the open, he's gone. He's a weapon. Now let's look at Arroyo, Freddie. After that game last year, Arroyo went on to get this, finished third in the Mission Valley League. You know, El Monte had the dream season. South El Monte tied them for the title. But Arroyo, you know, we talked about those Steven Rivera years where they had a hard time getting out of the first round of the playoffs. Last year they get out of the first round, and then they get into the second round and darn near beat Sierra Canyon. It's a team that found its identity late, and you always know what you're getting with Arroyo.
Yeah, I mean, Jim Singheiser is tough as they come as a coach.
Yeah.
And he's going to prepare you as well as he has. Yeah. And I thought last year, maybe it was early in the season, you know, they didn't have Steven Rivera. You're right. They were trying to find their identity. I just think schools like that in the Mission Valley, for them to be good, for them to be great, they need their neighborhood superstar. You saw it at El Monte last year with B-Mart. I think when you have guys like that, they can lead those football programs.
Yeah.
I don't think Arroyo necessarily had that guy last year.
Right.
Maybe a combination of them. And when you don't have that superstar to go with all of those guys that are just tough, gritty players that play hard football, it's tough. And I don't know that they have it this year.
Well, that's
quarterback is a situation you like.
Cotto's back. Nathan Cotto's back. And here's the thing, Fred. It's funny you say that. Because with Rivera, they never won that Arroyo, the SGV shootout in the summer. This year, they beat Diamond Bar in the championship and won the SGV shootout. Cotto looked fantastic. I mean, if anybody has had a better offseason as far as going from what he was last year to what he might be this year, then Cotto, I don't know who it is. He looks like, I'm not saying he's going to be Rivera or B-Mart or whatever, but he looks like he's going to be a very capable passer. Their receivers all look sure-handed. They're speedy. They have a nice group there. And Freddie, I wrote about this on my blog. Juan Hernandez, Robert Sanchez on the D-line. Two D-linemen pushing 270 pounds. I don't know how well they move. They say they're athletic. At a place like Arroyo, that's huge size.
Yeah.
That means they maybe can stack up to a Los Altos team that, Freddie, the reason for the hype isn't just because Hasagaba's back and Marcos is back and Jimenez is back. It's that offensive line. They have a fantastic, big, physical, athletic offensive line. Watch. They're going to be fantastic. So uh-oh, we're going to see a good matchup between right, those two big Arroyo D linemen and these Los Altos offensive linemen. And then Cotto and his receivers against what Los Altos has yeah, in the secondary and whatnot. I expect Arroyo to give a much better account of itself than 33-6 last year.
Well, I think Arroyo, they're always a good summer league team because I think Singheiser loves that. And they usually have a quarterback that
but can they haven't won that receivers tournament.
No.
But they did this year.
But they like to move the ball around.
Yeah,
right. And they have receivers. I think once you get into the Mission Valley League, they're going to be able to do what they want. But yeah, I don't think they're going to be able to do this against Los Altos.
Maybe
I
not.
Think now you're running up against teams that are just physical, and he's not going to have the time to throw and do the things he wants. Los Altos really handled him well last year, and they're better this year. Like
yeah,
you said,
are.
They have everybody back. I can't see how it's going to be.
They're
any
a top
different.
Five team in the area.
Yeah,
to
I can't.
Me,
and,
Freddie.
And
they
I,
really are.
And they're my favorite to win the Hacienda League. They
mine
really
too.
Are.
Yeah, mine
and,
too.
And I just can't see how it's going to be any different. I see the score being similar.
Okay, so Freddie's got Los Altos big. I've got Los Altos, but I think the game will be more competitive this year. Cotto will have a year under his belt. They'll have Juan Hernandez in the lineup. They don't have Peter Ojaloca, but they have good receivers. This will be an interesting game. I think Arroyo's going to come out jacked up, looking for revenge, looking to not get embarrassed. And they've heard all the hype about Los Altos, so they'll be ready. So I can't wait for this game on Friday night. I'll be out there. I'll be tweeting updates. Freddie will be at Amat for Amat Santa Margarita tweeting updates. Great Friday night coming up, everybody. Get out to a game and enjoy it. Thanks for watching.